ننتقل وإياكم إلى المؤتمر الصحفي للمتحدث الرسمي باسم اللجنة العليا المنظمة لاستقبال قداسة الحبر الأعظم، فإلى هناك
تشكيلاتهم
شهداء
الحشد الشعبي
وكذلك عوائل شهداء البشمركة.
هذه التعدديات في الحضور ضمت أيضا فئات من الشباب والنساء الفاعلات وكذلك شعراء وفنانين عراقيين. في قصر بغداد قدم قداسة الحبر الأعظم البابا فرانسيس كلمته موجها بمضمونها إلى كل العراقيين وإلى كل الديانات في العالم إلى ضرورة تجاوز لحظات الألم واعتماد خطوة جديدة في الدعوة إلى حوار الأديان. أكثر من 330 منهم من وسائل إعلام دولية وأكثر من 80 وسيلة منهم مثلت الإعلام المحلي. هذه الجهود وغيرها كانت قد استكملت من ذي قبل. فاللجنة التنظيمية التي ترأسها وزارة الخارجية العراقية ممثلة بالسيد الوكيل الأقدم لوزارة الخارجية العراقية وتنبثق عنها العديد من اللجان الفرعية كانت قد بدأت عملها منذ مدة واستكملت كافة الاستحضارات المتعلقة بالجوانب الأمنية والجوانب المتصلة بالمراسم، وكذا الحال بالنسبة القضايا التي تتعلق بتيسير منح سمات الدخول للإعلاميين والصحفيين من المحليين والدوليين ولجان أخرى أيضا على مستوى الحكومات المحلية في الناصرية وكذلك محافظة النجف الأشرف ثم في إقليم كردستان العراق في أربيل وكذلك أيضا في الموصل وقرقش. الجهات التي ساهمت بتقديم الدعم والإسناد وحشد جميع الجهود الوطنية العراقية كانت بمتابعة وإشراف دولة رئيس مجلس الوزراء السيد مصطفى الكاظمي وكذلك أيضا بمتابعة حثيثة وعلى مدار الساعة من السيد وزير الخارجية العراقي الدكتور فؤاد حسين والسيد رئيس اللجنة المنظمة لزيارة قداسة الحبر الأعظم إلى العراق. الجهات قدمت كافة الخدمات ويسرت كل ما يتصل بتحقيق الأهداف المرجوة من هذه الزيارة وزارتي الصحة والكهرباء قامت في أدوار جزيلة على مستوى وزارة الصحة فإما الفرق الطبية ووحدات الدعم الطبي الطارئة وتوزيع الكمامات وكذلك المواد المعقمة كانت في كل الأمكنة بشكل استجابة عاجلة وسريعة على مستوى وزارة الكهرباء فإن جميع الخدمات التي قدمت لإظهار هذه الزيارة بأفضل حجة وبأعلى مستوى من التنسيق على مستوى الكهربائية كذلك فإن الدوائر البلدية والخدمية مثلت بأمانة بغداد departments offering the في النجف الأشرف وكذلك في الناصرية from Nasiriyah and النجف الأشرف and موصل and أربيل كبيرة واستثنائية قرقوش. All these من تعبيد الطرق ورصفها على مستوى المقتربات والنقاط التي سيمر من خلالها أو يمكث فيها قداسة الحبر الأعظم لتأدية ما أسماه هو في كلمة
renovating the main roads leading to the place Palace of Heaven,
the place of Heaven, والإقامة في العراق لأيام متعددة. وكان شرطه يحدوه ويتملكه في أن يكون بين العراقيين وليسعى معه لأداء هذه الطقوس القلبية
he participated with high emotion and fully participated joyfully
at this الدكتور برهم صالح.
Of course at the presidential palace his excellency offered a symbolic visit to commemorate this historic visit of his holiness the supreme pontiff.
The gift was من البرونز
artistical paint made of bronze representing the pains that Christians suffered and experienced during the tough times, and this was a highly artistical painting work made by the late Iraqi artist
Muhammad
Al at the beginning of the 90s. And this expressed the pain that Christians suffered in all in these difficult moments. After the ceremony of reception, ceremony of official protocol, then His Holiness the Supreme Pontiff, he headed to the Church of Our Lady, the Lady of Salvation. And from he announced to all believers and all followers who participated in this mass,
and
he meant to remind everyone that we should always, he called for the brotherhood among all categories of the Iraqi population, and also all ministries and offices and departments, they did their utmost to make sure that this visit can be greatly covered, and this is this is a highly appreciated effort, and no wonder that it is of course done for a very, very special and very dear guest to Iraq. This is a very important visit. So we want to emphasize on the importance of Iraq also in the region. This visit also, it has a many symbolic meanings. It is to help Iraq to call for further support of Iraq.
And
also the Department of Communications and Media and Communications offered all the logistic facilities and assistance, technical access, such as the internet coverage, other governmental bodies and departments and ministries also. As far as the security aspect of this visit, there was an excellent security coverage,
and this
it was of course it covered all the route, and this was supervised by the president of the committee organizing this historic visit. All the security apparatus, the security coverage, it was secured by air security coverage that accompanied His Holiness from the international airport of Baghdad until the arrival to the palace, and then the church where the mass was held. All All these duties were supervised by the Presidency of the Republic, by Presidency of the Council of Ministers, and the General Secretary, and the Central Departments, and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Iraqi Ministry of Foreign Affairs. All those facilities were offered, and the follow-up of by the, the chief of the organizing committee also they instructed instructed all foreign embassies and consuls to issue and facilitate the issuing of visa, entry visa to Iraq for all the invited people who participated, all foreign visitors.
And
We are certain that this visit will, ensure
will
bring very positive results, and it will, of course, help to consolidate the mutual trust and to overcome the trauma of terrorism. And this will give, will raise up the morale of the Iraqi citizens, and of course will they are highly it has been appreciated that they defended all their religious and sacred holy memorials, and of course the reconstruction has been encouraged, and it received a very strong boost from during this the program that will be followed by His Holiness tomorrow, and the Iraqi government will be also covering and following it with equal similar protocol and also security coverage. So tomorrow he will start his trip to the holy Najaf, where he will be meeting with the Mr. Al-Sistani. He is the highest authority, religious leader. He is a highest religious leader. He will be meet
with
the Imam Sistani, his eminence Sistani. They will, of course, they will talk about the dialogue
and
try to push forward the harmony and dialogue and overcome and get rid of hatred,
and
to underline and to appreciate the very warm welcoming of the Iraqi citizens of His Holiness the Supreme Pontiff Pope Francis. And he has been he received the greetings and he was saluted all along all the way from the airport until the, so then he will then afterwards he will be heading to Nasiriyah region. And from there he will be heading to Zagurat, and that is the memorial of the great father, the Prophet Abraham. And we will have also tens of international press agencies and networks and TV, radio and TV networks. And there will be a full coverage of his. Also the National Iraqi Airlines are also facilitating the transportation to transfer all the delegations from one city to the other according to the schedule of His Holiness. And there will be special ceremony
في بغداد
this site of old, and then afterwards there will be a visit to the
church
in Baghdad, where he will be ending his historic trip. At the end of this press conference, I would like to thank you all for your kind
for being here,
and I renew my I would like to thank all the teams who really covered this visit with the protocol and everyone according to his it was, there was a high coordination between all these entities. Thank you. I thank Iraqi TV who showed exceptional efforts in covering, giving an excellent coverage, TV coverage of all the ceremonies.